So he said, she's a hussy, she's a hussy, she's a brazen hussy, I will not have any of this, she's a hussy. And I said, Richard, will you stop calling Resulka a hussy? She's lovely. Honestly, it was all him. I swear to God, it was all him.
I can't believe he said that.
I know, right?
I would never...
What a douche.
I would never do that. I would never say bad things about him. Because he's lovely.
That's a shame, because otherwise we won't have an episode title. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another spiffy episode of Tangential Recreation here on the Geek Planet Online channel. I am Matt Dillon, looking and feeling like shit. And joining me, instead of Mr. Cobbett, who is off doing, I don't know, important fucking journalisty things, probably shagging Peter Molyneux or something, I don't know. It's the aforementioned brazen hussy, it's Resulka!
Hello.
Hello.
That wasn't much to say there, but oh, hello.
Hello.
It is a very lovely Friday night for me. I don't have to think about work anymore. Oh,
which
God.
Nice.
The voices, I'm hearing them.
So, yes, this is Tangential Recreation, the video game show in which we have a rambling chat whilst playing a game as moving wallpaper. The game will give us something fucking up my intro, but never mind, we'll try that again. We will have 60 minutes on the clock.
Hey, you've got a game title now.
Sorry?
You've got a title for the video now.
Probably.
Yeah.
No, I still want you to say something nasty about Richard. And
oh,
then it will
I would
come full
never.
Circle, and you will be my dark minions. No. Anyway, we will have 60 minutes on the clock. The timer will start as soon as I remind Resulka what our finishing subject was.
Abusive Muppet relationships.
stop interrupting my fantastic intro. And our moving wallpaper this week is Dead Island, which it would have been Dead Rising 3, but my computer won't run it, because fuck my computer.
I had an outfit planned and everything.
And I guess this is kind of appropriate, because everybody in this game seems to be Australian so far, and so is Resulka, so...
Am I?
So I may have to put on a bit of an accent to fit in.
Oh, but, so might I.
So it's all good.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, so we're ready to go. So I just need to remind my good dear friend
yes. What
our finishing subject was, which was puppets in abusive relationships. Jesus Christ, we talk some shit on this show.
Yeah, and I've seen
and
it.
We're
so
away, and we're going to go do a mission. So, do you have any personal experience with puppets in abusive relationships?
Oh well, I can mention a couple. Let me start off with something that's actually Australian. And you just passed by some zombies that are just hanging out over here. Don't worry, I'll kick them.
I don't need to kill them, but you know what? I'm gonna... Taste my cleaver! Anyway, are we going to a Farscape place?
No! Although that is a good, how do I get the... Oh, left trigger. It's been a while since I've played this. Hey! Bad boy! Ow!
You leave my hussy alone.
That was not polite of him. No, there's a couple of things that you might have heard of, thing called the ferals.
Nope.
Oh. Well, they were basically feral animals that were living in a tip next to a house, and that was the whole show, and somehow it was like one of the most popular children TV show for a very, very long time in Australia. And it has a theme song that everyone always remembers because there's a rat called Radis, he's the leader of the bunch. There's a cat called Medigliana. She's fluffy, but she's tough.
Medigliana.
Medigliana! Get it right, slave. Oh, hello, friend.
Friend!
Bloody hell, let me kick this... Oh, sorry.
Hey, Ted B. Ted Bundy! It's him, he killed everyone.
I just see something and I go, oh. I was about to say that's his twin. Look, they're wearing the same pants.
Oh. Well, that's his fucking brother. You know, they're from Alabama.
Oh.
Does Australia have a version of Alabama? Like, we have Norfolk, like, all the incest jokes we made about Norfolk.
I'm not sure about incest jokes, but I do know that generally, well, for Melbourne, it would probably be Frankston.
Right.
They're not necessarily inbred, they're just hicks.
Ba-da-da-dang-dang-dang-dang-dang.
I've picked up a weapon.
What I found really interesting, and I learnt this from Billy Connolly's World Tour of Australia, actually, which was a great series. I know you lot have adopted him.
Yes, he's a good friend of ours. All of ours.
He's a great
guy. Yeah, but we gave you, what's it called, in place? Rolf Harris.
Yeah, thanks for that.
We wanted to keep him, but you guys really wanted him.
Yeah, the children of our country, thank you for that. Especially post-allegations.
Well,
I say allegations, he's been convicted.
Yeah, but it's still not as bad as, like, there was a show when I was a child called Hey Dad, and basically, Hey Dad was actually touching most of the children.
Thing is breaking down. Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, this thing is breaking down. Well, close the brass doors then, you racist stereotype. Sorry. I picked a Chinese character. I thought, you know, let's not go with your traditional cishet white guy.
Meanwhile, mine's like, hey, it's hotter than Hades in here. Here.
Okay, so I have no idea. We're completely lost. I have no idea.
Okay, I'm following you because I haven't played this game for a very long time.
Yeah, because reasons. Who's more foolish?
Because I'm taking care of you.
Can we go in here? Oh, we can go in this way. There we go.
Oh,
hey. Hi. Oh, do you know what? I keep misreading that. It says walker. I think it said wanker.
Well,
that's not very nice. He's already dead. I mean, what more do you want?
Oh, so I was telling you about the ferals. So basically, they would just, like, you know, they would live in a tip and, like, the neighbors would come over and be like, can you guys, you know, not live in filth today? And they'd be like, no, let's hang over in your house for some reason. And then they had a TV. They had a TV station at some point for some reason. It was weird. But that was I'd call that an abusive relationship.
Right. Oh, zombie!
Oh, cool.
Being attacked by a wanker.
Well, I'm trying to find you. Where did my friend the wanker go?
I'm not the wanker.
I was talking about the zombie. The zombie was my friend.
Why is the zombie your friend? No, you're being unkind. I don't think I like him. We did steal Team Minchin.
No, he's back.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Is he tired of our bullshit?
Oh, so probably. You went through that door. Oh, okay, because I walked around the building.
I've got the key card now, so.
And the passport.
And the passport?
Well, apparently that's what you were after, because we've been told to go.
No, it's a key card I was after. Now I think we might be after a passport.
Well, we're supposed
to. I don't know. I'm following the thing. Hey, wanker. Well. Oh, stay down. Bad wanker.
Yes.
Yeah.
He'll get a cramp.
So he's back. That's interesting.
Yeah, he was in a show called The Secret River, which was about, you know, when all the prisoners came to Australia.
Mm. Well, I mean, he's living over here. I thought, fuck off. He's living over here, so I'm assuming.
I think he's there's a couple of different people that seem to have dual citizenships. Or rather,
oh, I'm sure he's got dual citizenship, but I suspect he's doing what a lot of sort of performers in that position do, which is that. Oh shit! Which is that, you know, he's maybe going back home to visit for a couple of months, and while he's there, he's doing some work.
Yeah.
Like, you know, again, the aforementioned Billy Connolly does that quite a bit because he's got family all over the shop now.
Well, and now that he's got his other issues as well. Did you see that special that he did about the, it was Parkinson's as well as, was it cancer as well?
He's, like, don't even get me started. Like, Billy Connolly, growing up, well, still is, one of my all-time heroes.
Mm.
I love the guy, I really do. And, I mean, have you read his biographies that his wife did?
No, not those ones. I tend to stick more with Spike Milligan for my comedians' memoirs.
Well, there we go, we use that. Oh, does that mean I can drop shit? I don't know how this game works.
Who does? I'm
wondering if it's flimsy slicer, because that one's fine. Can I drop? Can I drop? Oh, there is a drop button. There we go. It's like Toe Jam and Earl, but violent.
Exactly, except you can't fall off another level.
Yeah, this is below. True. Well, if you do, there'll be zombies waiting for you or something. Yeah, I mean, they're great. His wife wrote them, of course. Oh, hello. Fuck, punch to the kidneys. I cut you, bitch. I cut you.
Yes, that you did.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, Pamela being a psychologist as well. Because she left acting, didn't she, Pamela
Beautiful.
Stevenson?
Yeah.
And comedy to become a psychologist. And she's a very good one now. And Billy was kind of like, okay, you know, rather than doing autobiography, you should be totally writing my biography because you get me and shit. So she did. So it's really interesting because, like, she delves into... There's a lot of stuff that he does... He was abused growing up.
Mm.
He was abused quite a lot. And there's a lot of... He's been through a lot, basically. Billy has.
Yes.
And yet, what I've always admired about him is that despite having been through that... Do I look injured or something? I seem to be limping or...
No, you seemed fine. You're a bit dirty. You dirty girl.
Dirty girl. Yeah, collectible item found. Nailed mod. Okay, at some point I'm probably going to be able to make weapons, I assume. Other players are waiting for you. Does that mean you?
Am I waiting for you? Are we supposed to talk to him? Okay. Oh, there we go.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, there are people that go through shit like that and they end up bitter and unkind.
Mm.
And Billy is somebody I've always taken inspiration from because he's been through a lot of stuff like that, a lot of nasty things in his life. And it's made him ridiculously kind and empathetic. You know?
Yeah, it does seem to be the way that you do tend to go one way or the other.
Exactly, and it's just like, being somebody, I've discussed my own mental health problems on this show before, so as Richard, you know, we're very supportive of that sort of thing, but I've always been of the opinion that no matter how messed up you are, there are a lot of things that are still a choice. Are you human or zombie? You're zombie. Fuck punch. Oh, that's you.
Ooh, thanks for the money, zombie.
Good old money, zombie. I keep trying to reload my knife. That's all those years playing Left 4 Dead for you.
Yes.
I can't help but feel that this should be third person, like Dead Rising.
Yeah, that,
maybe that's why it's first person.
I'd much prefer it that way myself, because I'm always terrible in FPSs where it's always like, oh, there's something behind me. You mean there's something behind me? What? I didn't know. Then I have to spin around and squish.
The problem is, I keep mistaking your character for zombies. Because I suddenly turn around and there's somebody lurking behind me and the lighting isn't so good.
Oh yeah, because I am pretty much just standing behind you. But
nail plank!
I'm just protecting you. I'm very protective of you, Matt. I've got to take good care of you.
Maybe I stab you in the face.
Don't stab me in the face, I'm protecting you.
Not you, Mr. Do-rag.
Oh, Mr. I own a surf shop on the beach.
Yeah, Mr. Bombastic, semi-fantastic. Yeah, I am of the belief that no matter how messed up you are, there are some things that are still a choice.
Ooh.
There are a lot of things you can't help, and I speak from personal experience of that, and there are certain things that require slaughtering crowbar, not just a regular crowbar, it's a slaughtering crowbar.
Yeah. Would have died.
Dude,
could've
you were
died.
Like 3 feet from your shop. You could have just walked away. They're zombies. They shamble.
And
you've got a killing crowbar.
And he was inside a car. Whoa. Sounds.
Oh my god.
Zounds. Oh.
Yeah, what the heck was that?
Bloody hell.
Sounds like Margot Kidder.
Yeah.
That's a bit harsh.
hello, you're awake. Dead.
Oh, zombies. Pretty as a picture. See, and it doesn't help that your model looks like a lot of the zombies. Look!
Oh!
Which one is you and which one's the... Oh. Look, infected muck, infecty pants. Get to fuck. Yeah, I mean... Like I said, there are a lot of things that can't be helped. There are a lot of things... There are a lot of learned behaviours that take a lot of effort to unlearn. But,
hello, incoming!
You know, I do think that to a point, and I do stress to a point because I don't want to upset anybody or belittle anybody's personal experience, but I do think to a point there are a lot of things that are a choice. And, you know, how you treat other people, not in terms of how you automatically react, because that, you know, your learned responses and your conditioned responses are not your fault, absolutely not, but in terms of how you choose to interact with people, you know, oh, that's just gross. Anyway, I don't want to sound like I'm on a high horse, I'm really not. I just think there's something really admirable about Billy, that all the things he's gone through, and he's gone out of his way to make people laugh and to help people and to do charity work wherever possible. Oh, I need some drugs or some energy.
Oh, drink. I just got a lovely close-up of that woman's butt as I killed her.
Sexy.
Yeah.
This is why this game is problematic. I stuck with it. Can we find an energy drink or something?
Why can't I
drink the beer? The product placement beer.
I found
is there
an
stuff
ID.
In there?
We've got...
canned food.
Yeah, delicious sardines.
Personal ID.
Right. You know you want some sardines. Sardines.
No, I don't want sardines. What I want is an energy... Oh.
That's not going to help you.
Well, do you know what? I can't actually see what I'm picking up. Because my screen is all sort of bloody and messed up.
See, if this was Dead Rising, you could just pick up one of these alcohols. And
yeah, I know.
Wow,
drink it.
You can really tell that I don't drink one of these alcohols.
One of these alcohols. Alcoholics. Does health regen in this? I don't know.
Yes. Because if you look at your health... Oh, I think so. Because if you look at your health, it's pulsating.
Yeah, but I just thought that was just one of the many ways in which this game was overly sexualized.
Oh, maybe. Hmm. Bit of a pulse.
Where am I going this way? And then on top, so like Billy spent his entire life just being kind, doing charity work.
Oh, pardon me.
And you've ruined the show.
I'm sorry.
With your real life noises.
I'm still impressed that I killed that zombie as I sneezed.
He's battled alcoholism.
Yeah.
You know, he's battled mental health issues, and he came out on the other side. And now it's like, here, have Parkinson's and cancer.
Yeah.
Because fuck you.
Do you watch At Midnight at all?
No, I don't. No. I don't know what that
is. It's basically like it's kind of like a panel show, but it's all internet based. It's American, but
right.
the main guy, the host of that, Chris Hardwick, he used to be an alcoholic as well, and he's very much on the supporting everyone. And whenever something happens in social media, it's always like, even though it's not part of the show. Like, in terms of, like, what they do to be funny during the thing.
I just got molested.
I'm coming for you. I thought you were still on the...
I don't know. Do I resurrect or do I respawn? What's the... Okay, I respawn. Don't bother coming for me. I died.
There was nothing left.
I still have... Go away, zomboid scum. Nobody loves you because you smell of dead things.
Oop. Hey.
I'm coming, Mr. Frodo! Oh, your Sam's coming! I'm going to save you, Mr. Frodo! I don't really know what I'm doing, sir, but I'm
cool.
Going to be bashing them orcs with a stick, sir.
But yeah, no, so even if it's not part of the show, he generally, like, does a big thing about it as well, about mental health and about, you know, how you treat people, and it's all...
Yeah. Because it needs to be talked about.
Oh, yeah, definitely, because, like, So much of the past has just been like, you know, oh, well, you know, it's a shame, but we don't talk about it. We don't want to talk about it because it's uncomfortable.
Yeah, but it's like, well...
And I mean, I can understand that a little bit, like, because, like, when I was in high school, like, I've always been lucky that I've never really been down or anything, but, like, I had someone that would just constantly, like, tell me about all their problems. I'm like, yeah, I can't really help you, but you won't leave me alone with this, and I've told you several times I can't help you with this. So.
Yeah. I mean, it's difficult. I always try to show support.
Oh, yeah. I think that's, like, the best thing you can do. But at the same time, it's just, like, I get why people think this is uncomfortable. I really get it.
Yeah.
Because I'm, like, she's making it my problem. I don't want it to be... Oh, here's an energy. Oh, actually, I need it. This one's mine.
Yeah, don't worry about it. I'm gonna... I've still got a paddle somewhere, I think.
Where are you hiding it on that dress of yours?
See, I've got weapons. I've got so many weapons that I can't use.
Because they're in your hammer space. They're in that sexy skirt of yours.
Yeah, let's go with no. Yeah, I think no. No is good, you know. Alright, taste my pipe. Hello, level 2 Walker. Walker, Texas Ranger.
Yeah. Digger. I'll take that.
Yeah, I mean, I always try to show support for other people, and if people want to vent and they've chosen me to vent at, that's cool too, you know? Because if something's making me uncomfortable, if I don't think it's appropriate, I will say so. So, and if I haven't said so, you know, that's cool. And sometimes people just need to be able to vent, they just need to be able to talk, and that's cool.
Oh, you need to come in here.
Sometimes people, like, because I've been in that position, sometimes it's like, actually, venting is not just what I need. I need to... Ooh, itch. I need to find, you know, there's something specific I need. And sometimes it's difficult to articulate, you know?
Oh, yeah, and I
this thought... is why it's important to talk about. If we don't bury these things, if we talk about them regularly, then... we can get, you know, you can get help, you can feel better.
Yeah.
So, this will really, we've done an episode, we've talked about this before, and that'll be a boss thing. So,
yeah.
Should we talk about...
bosses?
Yeah. Should we talk about Farscape, since we were talking about abused puppets in Australia?
Oh, well, you know, like, I love Farscape, I mean, that's pretty much all I've got about it.
Come into the light, my dear zombie friend. I shall destroy you. Did you never watch Farscape?
Oh, no, I watched it all the time. What are you talking about? Crazy boy. Whoa.
Here he comes. He's coming out now. Should we see if we can back him into the fire and make him burn?
Throw the freaking Molotov. There we go.
Oh, was that you, was it? You made a Molotov.
I had one from the last time I played this game. Up.
Well, he's a-burning.
And now we just have to wait for the fire to go... Oh, shit, there's a bomb behind me.
I think I'll burn, because that's fun. And also because I'm an idiot. And now I need drinks or...
Yeah, well...
Oh, energy drink, there we go.
I was about to say, this place is a... place that... Oh, that's right, we have to clear this place out.
Oh, really?
We had to clear it out, but then it becomes a safe zone.
Staying alive. Sorry, electronic scrap. Which is also an insult in Transformers.
Oh.
Electronic scrap.
Oh, $5 in the toilet. Just what I've always wanted.
Reminds me, did you guys get Bottom out there?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I love Bottom Live.
Can I get out there?
No, you come through this way.
I can't see a bloody thing. Is there a
It's dark. Oh, hello. Stop it. Bad zombie. Zombie hurt now. Zombie learns lesson? No, zombie does not learn lesson.
It's pitch black, and I'm apparently near a zombie. I do not like this.
No, I killed it. It's dead. It's a dead thing now. Oh, hello.
Oh, good-o. I still can't see a damn thing.
Can you see my torch?
No. Which means you're probably very far ahead of me.
No, I'm not really. I just saw you through the peephole before. Here I am. Over here. Turn around. Hello.
Oh, there you are. Hi.
Yeah.
Hi.
So... from memory, it's somewhere over here.
Do you know what's really annoying?
What?
Hey. What's really annoying is that you can probably see quite well because you're holding that torch.
No, I'm actually not got the torch on. I just turned my gamma all the way up because I hate darkness scenes. I mean, it's great for atmospherics, but at the same time, it's just like, fuck, I just want to see stuff.
Let's just do that right now. Video.
I just want to be able to see everything. They're like, look for the logo.
Oh, that's a separate option. Oh, shut up, yeah.
I'm trying to remember what we have to actually do here.
Oh, that's better. I can actually see what's going on now. Yeah, I cheat every time. Please, turn your lower your gamma until you can barely see the logo. Right, I'll be going the opposite way then.
I want to see everything.
Well, I want to see what the hell I'm doing. I had to do that when I did the video for Gone Home. I had to do that. There was a point where it was supposed to be dark and spooky, and it was, but...
Oh, that's right, we got under the roof.
I've just picked up meat. Random meat. I love the fact that the weapons start getting distressed the more you use them.
Yeah.
And bent and... Oh, right, okay, so...
Oh, that's right.
I can repair shit, or...
Yeah, there's a radio thing, though. I can hear it. He was talking. Speak again, man.
Speak again, radio man. Okay, so have I just repaired my diving knife? No, I have to hit.
My
scotching. Yes, let's repair that. I have monies, upgrade. Can I create stuff? Rip them off.
Go to the lifeguard tower and get rid of all the undead in this area. I thought we already did that.
Maybe we did, maybe we didn't.
Well, there's definitely no one left inside.
There's a little skull on the minimap, which means there's a zombie we've got left to kill.
Hmm.
Probably is on the map. Probably is on the roof or something.
Yeah, but the roof is locked at this point.
Right. Okay, so we need to segue here, because we're sort of... We're supposed to be rambling and talking stuff.
Yeah, but we're actually talking about the game.
We're just talking about the game we're playing, which, as regular viewers to the show will know, this is not the way this show goes. We're not allowed to talk about the game. Don't be silly. So, if we're not going to talk about the game, what are we going to talk about? So, okay, so... Farscape fan, what are your big fandoms then, SF-wise?
I like a lot of things.
There are more zombies now.
Yeah, are they downstairs?
I don't know.
Well,
they just appeared.
I just opened the roof. Oh, hello.
Ah.
Okay. So come up into this roof area. Ah, yes, hello, my precious little pretty friends. Smack.
Righty dokey, matey skip. Oh, hello, wanker.
I like a lot of things. Basically, I like anime generally, if it's fucked up.
Oh, really? Okay, well, there's something we can talk about. So, Full Metal Alchemist?
I did watch it when it first came out, but I didn't actually, spend that much time with that for some reason, which is probably heresy.
You really need to spend more time with Full Metal Alchemist, because it's not only an awesome story, when it gets fucked up, it gets really fucked up.
Well, the story I always tell, for a long time that, I used to watch all types of anime, even the really... cutesy stuff and the etchy stuff, and then I saw Ergo Proxy, and then I didn't need anything else. I just had Ergo Proxy.
Yeah, I've got Ergo Proxy kicking around somewhere.
God, I love Ergo Proxy.
I'm sure.
Aha! I found the room. I found the special room.
Hug of death.
Hug of death. Bad friend.
I adored Full Metal Alchemist. I adored Attack on Titan.
The one that I saw not recently, a couple months ago now, was Psychopaths, and I love that. I love when, they create, a whole society, and then, talk about the rules that they've come up with as, the ideals, and then point out how it would never work.
Means nothing to me. I've never seen the series, but...
Okay, so basically, Psychopaths is that, they're sort of police detectives, but they go around with, these scanners that check mental health of people to see if they're gonna, become psychopaths.
Right.
Or they call it the crime coefficient. And so basically, they're we're able to stop crimes from happening because we're able to protect the people that will start becoming criminals. So, which is great, but the problem is that the moment anyone sees any sort of crime or mind break, they go, well, this person's gonna become a criminal at some point. It's like, what? No, so
it's like the Minority Report problem.
Yeah, so it's basically also the detectives that, or not the detectives, but the officers that actually go and check out all these things. They have to actually get regularly checked, and so they have a particular some of the officers are actually psychopaths that are controlled, they wear a collar and all that, so that it's sort of so they get in the minds of the psychopaths so that their officers don't have to, so their crime coefficient won't go up so quickly.
I'm with you.
But, like, one of the main psychopaths of it, he actually used to be, like, a really good detective. So it's just sort of like, well, eventually you're going to end up here, but I'm going to try my best to make sure that you don't.
Okay. I kind of get where you're coming from then.
Yeah.
It's like World of Warcraft. We need to head towards the exclamation marks and talk to people who want us to do shit. I bet there's somebody back up on that roof now.
Don't think someone... Oh, I'll go up and check. But, oh, hello. There's someone...
this guy?
Hey, I'm down. Yeah.
I don't care.
Oh, no, it's a piece of shit antenna. We can't have that.
I was clearly here on holiday. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Do we choose
quests? Yeah, so we choose quests, but I just picked that one for us. Because I'm nice.
I was wondering if you can, like, pick up multiple quests and then...
I think you can, actually.
Switch between them, or...
Yeah, spark plugs, baby.
And, you know... you know, I'm an NPC, so I can't possibly, like, take 5 steps outside and find that shit for myself.
Yeah, no. See, that's one of my big problems about most of these games, is no one actually does anything for themselves.
I know, like, NPCs, like, how do they live? Well, they live because... Oh, hello. A disabling stick!
I suppose,
feeble
like,
mace,
at least, like, you know, with...
Reliable hammer. Tiring homemade machete.
I suppose there's one thing. Yeah, remember me, mate. Ugh.
Right, let's sell some shit. Let's sell my flimsy wrench and my frail homemade. Oh no, that stuff you've given me, maybe not.
Though that's one thing that I actually quite like about Dead Rising 3 so far. The fact that, you know, like, because I actually spoke about this with Richard because I was trying to talk him into playing it again because the first area really is quite dull and boring, and he was like, it didn't grab me. But then it got really fun, especially, like, once you start combining machines into, like, steamrollers, and then, like, you know, have, like, a motorcycle with a steamroller in the front that shoots fire.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but one of the things that they do differently with the survivors is that certain survivors will go take care of themselves, so you don't have to, like, you know, get them to a safe house. But other ones will actually become companions that you can pull off, like, you can go, like, oh, I'm going on a busy mission, so why don't you come with me? So, but if you don't want them, then they're just they're in the safe houses, they're actually a board that you can put them away. So,
oh, right, okay.
But it seems that there's just a lot more, I find with the people that are hanging around, they're actually doing stuff. So it's sort of like, if they're a friendly NPC, then you generally, you know, help them out, and then they go off, and sometimes you'll see them again later,
right,
doing something
how
else.
Quests. There's a quest thing.
Quests.
Bloody health service. Let's get out there and do some stuff.
Yes.
So let's go get the single amplifier. Let's do that quest.
Yeah, the sooner you get home.
Whatever. No, nobody likes you, pal. Yeah.
Oh, that's right. We get to pick up a car at some point.
I really liked the Dead Rising series.
Mm. I never finished either of the first two. I love them dearly, but, like, I'm terrible with the psychopaths and the bosses, so I just ended up just killing zombies until I died.
Well, there are certain games that I would only ever play in co-op.
Mm.
And the Dead Rising games are like that. I like co-op. I like playing co-op games with friends. Especially games with a quest structure.
Oh, I think there's stuff coming out this way. Oh, I hear some. I hear them.
Stay down. Oh, that's a lovely view of your backside, lady.
I know, right? You like what you see? Oh, hello.
Not so much. It's a car part. I'm just... There we go. Oh, so that's what those little symbols in the mini-map mean. Those are things we can collect from broken cars.
Oh, good.
Stay down. Oh, that's fun. This is a decent weapon.
Oops. Ow, ow, ow. Do not stand on fire once you've lit a zombie on fire.
That's a life lesson that I think we can all enjoy.
Yes.
And take something from, you know? Right.
I hope. Part. One can only hope.
One can only hope. Yeah, I mean, the games that I would only ever play in co-op, Dead Rising being one of those. I do like co-op games. I like getting together with a friend or something with a mission-based structure. So you can be like, all right, I've got an hour this evening. We can get a couple of missions done.
Yeah, and one of the things I really like about Dead Rising is just basically that you're basically just going around a place, picking stuff up and, like, experimenting. So it's basically you get to just be a dick, but it's an acceptable way of being a dick.
Yeah, kind of. I mean, I always found, back in the old PS2 days, the Lego Star Wars games, or the Lego whatever games, some of the earlier ones, I always found a lot of fun, because... Oh, hello.
Ew, he went squish.
There you go. He did go squish. Because there was a lot of, like, emergent gameplay in that, where, yes, there was, like, the mission-based stuff, but there was no real penalty to dying. Like, you exploded and all of your pips went everywhere.
Oh, thank you for the assist.
Hey, no probs. That will be a metal box that will probably have a cool weapon in, apparently.
Oh, bandages. Bandages work well. Ah! I knew I could hear something!
Yeah, apparently I can't get at that from where I am.
Thank you for the nails.
Replies lockstick... What? This is an RPG now.
Yeah, pretty much. Didn't you realise that it was before? No, I don't have lockpicking skills.
No, this is one of the many things that I picked up in a Steam sale with the thought of... for, like, £2.
It's an action RPG.
With the idea of playing it at a later point and then never got around to it. And lucky I did, because now we have a game to play.
Yeah, after I bought you Dead Rising 3.
After you bought me Dead Rising 3 because you super wanted to play it, and then yes. It was like, yeah, that right, yeah, that runs like shit.
Such a shame. I'm having such joy. Such joy.
Oh, do you know, I am so bored with zombies.
Yeah, generally yeah. So am I, but something about Dead Rising just, you know, generally the moment someone goes, it's zombies, I go, I don't care. But Dead Rising, I think it's just that it's just so wacky. Which is kind of weird after it had, like, such a gritty opening. It's like, oh, so much bad stuff happening. It's like, yeah, I don't care about any of this.
Yeah, but I mean... They've always been done with a liberal dose of humour, haven't they?
Yeah. I'm not sure... I can't really think that this game is any... You know, it's not really funny in any way. Other than the terrible accents.
Yeah, it's not intentionally funny. Yeah. In any way. And it is overly sexualized, I've noticed. Like, I know that when the collector's edition, the most recent one, was released, there was a big issue with that.
Well, I think also, like, at least with, like, Dead Island, it's... I'd actually give it a pass, just because, like, this whole island seems to be one of those, you know, party towns where it's just basically, that's all we do. Which is, you know, my general problem with society, that all that anyone seems to want to do is party and drink.
Yeah, but I mean, like...
Let's go dancing, Matt. Let's go swing dancing.
Let's go swim dancing. Yeah, but the thing is, even in tropical environments, people don't wear nothing but bikinis all the time.
No, but we are on a resort, so there would be a lot of people just wearing bikinis and perhaps a, you know, caftan over that.
Maybe so, but then where are the men in Speedos? There's always a dude in Speedos.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not saying I want to see that, but I'm saying if we've got women in bikinis, we should have guys in Speedos.
Oh, definitely. In fact, I thought that there were men in Speedos in this game.
Do you know what? If there are men in Speedos, cool. But we've not met any yet.
No.
And we've met plenty of women in very skimpy bikinis.
Who are these people that just leave money in their bags? You're not supposed to leave money in your suitcases, people. Keep your bags with your money on you at all times.
I think you've got to, like, the central conceit you've got to accept is that, like, this in video game land, people do stupid shit like that. It's like, like Legend of Zelda or Final Fantasy. You just walk into people's houses and take their stuff.
Yeah, I do enjoy a game where, like, what's it called? Like, Return to Zork. Had that where that, you know, if you took something from someone that you weren't supposed to, the Wanderer would come up and take all your inventory items. I mean, it's something that you kind of don't want it to happen, but at the same time, it's like, well, that's nice that they actually include that. What is that pose that you were holding right then?
I don't know. I was reacting to a zombie that was already dead.
Well, you won't be able to see it now, but when you're editing it, you were like, oh, you're going to love it.
Well, I won't be able to see it when I'm editing, surely, because it'll be my video.
Well, no. But I did the pose. It was great. You'll see. Very meta. Or something.
Oh, I will say for Dead Island, when you kill things, it makes you feel badass. Which makes me happy.
It does have a very nice haptic feel, force-back feel to it when you hit something.
Yeah. It's why I like Fallout 3, because when you do a critical hit, and especially with the bloody mess perk, you get that slow-mo shot of somebody exploding or whatever.
Yeah.
And you think it would get old, and it never does.
Never does, yeah. I'm not too much of a fan of the slow-mo one in this, just because generally you're not looking at anything particularly interesting when it goes slow.
I don't know. I kind of like the effect. It's a lot more subtle. The action doesn't stop.
Yeah. I think it's mostly that so far I've just been seeing butts.
Yeah.
More and more butts.
Talk to James. You're not boss of me.
Don't yell in your face. Did you see that? How rude.
Go inside. James.
He's like right up in your face going, go inside. You're mean. Wait. Who looks like Jesus?
Crippling flanged mace.
That's
the name of my Metallica cover band.
Well, it looks like Jesus. Oh, crippling flanged mace. Funnily enough,
diabolical heavy mornings. These are all metal band names.
Like, what's it called? Like, my cousin and I were like once we were going to make like a band, and it was going to be called Clevis versus Flange.
Like it.
Yeah, and it was like our song was Peter Venkman and the DeLorean.
Okay, that just makes me twitch.
In a good or a bad way.
Not canon.
Yeah, definitely not canon. It never was going to be canon. But that's the great thing about songs. They don't have to be canon. They just have to tell a story. Like,
Sorry, carry on.
Peter Venkman lost the Ghostbusters car, so he had to borrow a car from Doc Brown.
So presumably you have read Ready Player One.
No, I have not.
You should read Ready Player One.
Okay.
I'm not even going to tell you why. Just trust me.
Have you found James?
Read Ready Player One by Ernest Cline.
Yes. I found...
The basic premise for Ready Player One is it's basically Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, but with a virtual world and an impossible-to-find Easter egg.
Ooh.
Yeah. Like, dystopian future, everyone's escaped into this virtual world. The creator of said virtual world dies. On the morning that he dies, every single user of the Oasis, which is, like, one part World of Warcraft, one part Second Life, and now most people just live inside there and only come out to the shitty real world. Oh, you've got the quest for us. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I remember a long time ago there was an article by Yahtzee Croshaw when he was writing for Hyper Magazine, which is an Australian magazine. But he basically theorized that once actual VR pretty much, like, you know, you can live inside this machine, you're not coming back out again. Why would you want to?
Okay, apparently I haven't talked to the guy.
Oh.
So I have.
Sorry, you're waiting for me. Birds?
Why are there zombies?
Why are there zombies? Because there shouldn't be. Sorry, what were you trying to do?
I was trying to go back to where we were and talk to the guy that I didn't talk to. Because I assumed that because you did, I'd complete the quest.
Well, you should have.
No, I'm so wrong.
Through this door. Well, this guy doesn't want to talk to me.
He doesn't want to talk to me either.
But that's because you're not here. Aren't you trying to get the guy upstairs?
Yeah.
Well, you're not upstairs.
No, this guy over here, where I am. This Davin Bark dude.
Davin. Oh, that guy. Sorry.
Yeah, this is where I need to be, apparently.
Yeah. Thanks, American man.
find my... What, oh.
This woman doesn't want us. This guy doesn't want us. No, hello.
What's with the flag?
Everyone loves a good flag.
Seriously, though. What? I'm following the little dots and the little curves.
Okay.
Maybe I have to do something. Because I've not been paying attention to the dialogue, because I've been talking to you, I'm wondering if I'm... Right, hang on. Let's... Yeah, I've changed quest and Mark has moved. And so obviously we need to do things for these douchebags before we...
Well, we can go back.
No, but I think we're supposed to go through that door, but I don't think we can get through it until we've done his
quest. No, so... Hello, Evan. Get in the car, I'm driving.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm a very good driver, thank you very much.
Are you now?
I drive to work every day.
Yeah, but like in Australia, isn't there like nothing on the roads? Like you might hit
a wall and that's it. Okay, so like if it's not peak hour, I can get to work in half an hour. But if it's peak hour, it takes me 2.5 hours.
Peak hour.
Peak hour. P-E-A-K.
Oh, peak hour. Well, you and your silly accents.
You know, most people seem to think I'm British for some reason. I can't work out why.
Yeah, no, Americans think you're British because Americans have a terrible ear for accents.
No, Australians think I'm British.
Australians think you're British.
Yes. So,
well, you hang with a lot of Brits.
And Americans.
And Americans, this is true. Maybe I've never an accent.
Maybe. But I had this terrible nighttime job for a long time where I was just basically, hey, you broke my window!
Mother.
That I was basically scanning checks. Scanning checks? Yeah, I was scanning checks. It was terrible.
We've gone the wrong way. Look, turn around.
You're right.
Going the wrong way.
Sorry, my camera's right in front of the mini-map. Ouch.
Oh, I'm really good at driving. Look at me going entirely the wrong way.
But, and they kept asking me every week when I was going home. And I was like, I was born in Melbourne? I'm going the right way now, right?
Yes.
Yes.
You are. Have you not got a mini-map?
My camera's right in front of it.
Oh. Maybe move that?
Okay,
we've passed it. Turn. Right. Turn around. Oh, that wasn't good.
The cars in this are quite terrible.
Stop. Keep going. Forward. Inch forward. Keep going. I'm not sure where we're supposed to...
No.
Keep following the road.
I'm just looking around and see where turnoffs are.
Yeah, lovely turn-off, but at some point those dots are going to stop. Keep going. Oh, I think we're supposed to do the dog leg here. Turn. Turn left.
Have you not noticed the bus right there?
Maybe we're supposed to get in the bus. I don't know. Maybe we're supposed to get out here. Or turn this way.
Oh, petrol! Is this the petrol mission?
I don't know. But our car is smoking, we don't want it to explode. How do I get out?
X. Marks the spot.
Now, how do I never speak of this again? Press X to never speak of this again.
Oh, I'm afraid it's not going to work.
Oh, you know, I've been playing Plague Inc.
Oh, yes.
Which is a ridiculously fun game. Have you played that?
No, but I know of it.
Yeah, so for those who haven't played Plague Inc., you play a disease. It's the entire game is so simple, like it can always be something from like the home micro days, like the ZX Spectrum days. I'm wondering, do we have to go like round here maybe?
I'm just following you.
No, I'm talking, I'm sort of thinking out loud, I'm trying to follow the dots, so I think we've got to go
Oh, behind you!
Hey, zombie face.
I'm taking this money, this is mine.
Nice try, I took it.
No, you didn't. I got it.
It can always be a game from the old ZX Spectrum days where it's played from a map and occasionally you flick to other screens. But you get to name your disease. So you and you unlock the different disease types, because the different vector types, as they all play a little bit differently. So you start with bacteria, which is like pretty much the easiest thing to learn, of course,
and the most disgusting. So and you're crouching along the ground.
That'll be why I'm going small, slow.
That's why you're going small. Yes.
You get to name your disease, and then you have to pick a starting country. And of course, the starting country will... Poor fella. Never even had a chance. Your starting country will also denote like the disease's like inbuilt property. So you start in a hot country, it's going to be used to hot climates.
Yeah.
Start in a cold country, it's going to be used to cold climates, and so on.
And if it starts in Melbourne, it's going to be very confused.
And then you... Basically, as more people get infected, you earn DNA points, which you can then spend on evolving your disease. And the more you evolve the disease, there are evolutions, there are properties you can give it that make it more contagious, which in turn net you more DNA points. There are properties you can give it that make it more deadly.
Ooh, new friends!
Friend! Goodbye, friend.
I think he died. Ooh, meat.
I'm going to pick up the random meat, which I'm sure is perfectly edible and not at all diseased human flesh.
Delicious.
And the idea, the aim of the game is to infect the entire world and kill everyone. And this is where strategy starts coming into it, because you, if the deadlier your disease effectively is, the more likely it is to kill, often goes hand in hand with how quickly it spreads, but then it makes it more noticeable. And if it gets noticed by the health community, then people start working on a cure sooner.
Well, it's also... The problem I generally... not the problem, but, the thing that I notice, especially, say, for example, vampirism. Anytime that the plot says, we want to get rid of all the humans. Why? They're your food source. If you're all vampires, you're not going to be able to eat anything.
Yeah, but you're assuming that the disease is a protagonist. It's not. The idea is just to make a highly successful world pandemic that's going to kill all the things.
I would go with mutate. Then it can keep learning, keep evolving.
Mutate. Viruses mutate more readily than bacteria and so on and so forth.
Oh, no, I was saying that the actual people that it affects. Because if you kill everyone off, then eventually it's going to die off because it's not going to have anything to go with.
Well, there is a disease that does that. There is a vector that does that. So as you unlock, I unlocked brain worms.
I just got money out of some woman's butt.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's the best place to find money, I find.
Oh, you got a nice box.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm... I can pick it up, I can't... And lob it. I can't actually open it. It's got nothing in it. Oh, this way, I think, for you players
left,
and things.
You left your crate behind, so I decided to bring it.
What? Because it's my... my
it's your baby!
Cube.
Yes.
I'm just companion cube.
Gonna put it down while I...
Yeah, so you can unlock brain worms. Brain worms are really interesting. It's like bacteria, it's just a case of infecting and then becoming deadly and killing blah blah blah. Like when you get brain worms, I fell down. When you get brain worms, as a vector, they control the host. So it's not a... You should still evolve deadly symptoms because you still want to kill the entire world eventually. But in the meantime, you can evolve abilities such as the ability to program your victim, your host, to travel to a specific country so they'll infect that country.
Mm.
So bacteria spread on the wind via animals and things. With brainworms, you're better off evolving the ability to infect other countries directly, yada, yada, yada. It's a lot of fun. But anyway, the thing that made me think of it was... One of the fun things is throughout the game, you get a little news ticker that gives you the news updates, and a lot of them are quite relevant. So it'll say something like heavy flooding in this area, which is your clue to evolve your vector so that it can transmit via waterborne.
Mm.
It could be a waterborne disease and stuff, or mass migration of birds. So you start infecting birds and stuff.
I'm on a boat! Don't mind me.
I'm on a boat. Take a long, hard look. I think we have to go around this way. Okay, so ducking that gets me underwater, apparently.
Not a place you want to duck.
That's nice.
You're not a goose, but after all.
You get joke news items. Which can be quite funny. Like some of them can be quite touching. They react to things that happen in real life. So one of them pops up is Terry Pratchett voted best author ever, ever, ever.
But that's a true real story, though.
Yeah, absolutely. You get stuff like Harry Potter reboot. Like, there's lots of fan-baiting stuff like Harry Potter reboot considered.
Sorry, you just said Harry Putin, and I'm now
Harry Putin.
Got the strangest
You're
Russian.
A wizard, Vladimir.
Now ride on this horse without a shirt on. I like it that way.
And then invade the Ukraine.
They're dementors. No way, that wouldn't make any sense. They're
no,
death eaters.
No.
They're death eaters. There we go.
There's something. They're borscht eaters. Because Russia.
But borscht is
Shut
nice.
Up. I don't even know what borscht is.
It's got potato in it. It's a bit
right,
spicy, tomatoey. Richard wouldn't
it?
Like
it.
Is it
a stew?
Yeah, it's kind of like between a stew and a soup.
Oh, right, okay. I might have to try that.
Generally, people serve it. Well, no, it can be cold or hot.
Generally, people serve it. What this is like.
I was about to say, generally, people serve it cold, but then I remember I've also had warm borscht, although some people would say that warm borscht is not good borscht. I like saying borscht.
Borscht. Yes, borscht. I've noticed that. I will, as I was mentioning, I think off air, I will generally try anything. I used to be really fussy eating as a kid.
Oh, no,
adult,
I'm pretty fussy. But
yeah.
It's just all the things that they're like, it's got this and it's got this. I'm like, okay, I like those things. I probably would not eat this on a regular basis, but I will try it.
So what's like your number one, like, ugh, that's not going in my mouth food?
Tomatoes. Generally,
tomatoes.
And this is the thing. I like processed tomatoes. I do not like the textures of actual tomatoes.
Ooh, I have skill points.
Yes.
I have skill points.
Yes.
Let's spend my skill points. What do I spend them on?
But
of course, all of my...
Generally, the whole thing with me is that if it squishes in a particular way, I will be revolted by eating it. It's kind of like, well, like, my mother made a roast chicken today, and then she just, like, and then I was like, what happened to the broccoli? And she said, no, this isn't broccoli, it's zucchini. And I went, exactly. And, oh. No, I don't mind, like, cucumber cubes, although I'm not a big fan of them, but, like, she had roasted this thing that, so it was hard on the outside, and it was, like, jelly on the inside. Sorry.
Yeah,
I'm
just thinking about it, aren't you?
Yeah, I had to, like, eat it with, like, carrots, and I'm not a big fan with carrots, but I was like, this is the only way this is going down.
Yeah, you really are fussy. I love vegetables.
Oh, no, I like, vegetables that I like, I will love it. Like, what's it called, like... Oh, I'm all over broccoli. I could eat broccoli every meal. I shouldn't, but I would. Broccoli.
See, I have an issue with what I call farty veg. If it smells like a fart when it's cooking, I won't eat it. Except
well, you're not
that
cooking it right, then.
Well, no, it's there's a lot of vegetables like broccoli, cauliflower, that are quite sulfurous.
Yeah, I don't like cauliflower.
Yeah, as my buddy Dave says, although I'm sure... As I recall, this was a phrase he borrowed off a mate of his. It's like, I hate cauliflower. It doesn't even have the common decency to photosynthesize. So why would I eat it?
Yeah.
It's like underdeveloped broccoli. I mean, I've developed quite a liking for broccoli. I like tender stem broccoli.
I like broccolini. Broccolini.
You like what?
Broccolini. It's like a really tall, thin broccoli.
Yeah, that's what we call tender stem.
Oh, I thought that was something else.
Maybe they're two different.
There's many different types of things.
You guys call courgette zucchini, so, like, what do you know?
I don't care if you're trying to run a business here. How about I stab you instead?
Stab him in the face. Oh, wait, he's an NPC. He's probably
He doesn't care.
So, me, when I was a kid, I didn't like anything too piquant or anything vinegary. So, like,
oh, I can't stand vinegar. Vinegar's the worst.
Like, oh, I love it now. I love stuff like that.
Nah.
Oh, hello. We've gone somewhere.
But then, like it's sort of like desserts. I'll eat a lot of types of desserts, but Fondant? No. Anything that tastes chalky? I don't like textures. Textures are bad.
Yeah, I was going to say, I've noticed that your kind of texture is kind of usually like, I don't mind tomatoes, but I can't stand uncooked tomatoes.
Ugh.
Yeah, cooked tomatoes I'm fine with. Raw tomato, it has to be really thinly sliced. Let's find another quote.
No, because it's all about like how it just squishes and... Because it's sort of like, I like tomato soup, I like tomato juice, I like tomatoes that have been cooked in a sauce. Just can't stand actual tomatoes. And pumpkin. Pumpkin makes my gag reflex react.
Yeah, I mean, so like my thing with it is sort of, if it's very thinly sliced, it's actually kind of cool. I like.
Oh, the car's back! Get in the car!
Oh, not the car. Not the car.
Get in the car.
No, I'm going to die.
Well, just tell me where you want.
I like a nice fresh BLT that's got thinly sliced tomato. That's quite nice. But yeah, like big chunks of juicy tomato. Like, it's because it's a fruit, but it's savoury.
Mm.
I think that's the problem. Like, it's big and it's crisp on the outside, big and squishy on the inside and juicy. And I don't like that when something's savoury. I like crisp vegetables. I like carrots. I like sugar snap peas.
Our sugar snap peas are quite good, as long as they're still in the pod.
Sweet corn. Like sweet corn.
Oh. Sweet corn, I'm on the fence, but I really like actual corn. So where would you like me to go, sir? Forward, right, forward,
yeah,
right.
Forward. Yeah, you're not following your mini-map, are you? Because you can't see.
I can't see it.
Oh, well, I've got to direct you now. This is a really interesting video. Matt reads the map. Yeah, so keep following the road.
Sorry, I had to.
Stopping only to murder people, apparently.
Well, it's an important thing. Oh.
Damn it.
There we go, I fixed it.
Keep going, just keep going.
Keep on driving, all right.
Yep, keep on driving. Although, stop here. There are skulls on the map, which means there are things we're expected to kill. So let's go do that. I want to kill shit. I want to kill things with my cleaver of doom.
Alright, this way.
Hey, the zombie face.
Hey, we were over here before.
I love you, and I'm going to stab you in the face with this silly accent.
You sounded Texan for some reason.
Yeah, I know. That was the point. My... That guy had glue. I shall sniff it later.
Ew.
No, I don't advocate that sort of thing at all.
No, what I like about glue is putting it on my hands and ripping it off. Come on, everyone loves that.
Oh, somebody posted a meme about that the other day. Like, kids these days have iPhones. When I was a kid, I was happy just painting my hand with glue to peel it off like skin. It's like, it's totally... Mind you, kids still do that. Memes like that kind of bug me a little bit. I also hate that the whole... You know, only 80s kids or only 90s kids will remember this. Because it's just like blatant repost bait. What really made me laugh was, what's really funny is, like, I've seen the same memes over and over again. And they've just kind of evolved as generations have got older to make sure more people repost them. So, like, you must have seen it on Facebook or whatever, social media, the whole thing of, you know, when I was a kid we played outside and we came in when it was dark and we rode our bikes and we didn't have to be afraid of strangers and blah 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 blah, my life was better, blah blah, bullshit, right?
Yeah.
And when I first started seeing these memes on social media, like on Facebook, like years ago, it was like only 80s kids will remember this. I saw one the other day with no change in wording, but it's like only 70s, 80s, 90s, and 90s kids will remember this. It's like, oh, come on. This same meme was being so smug and elitist about being born in the 80s over being a 90s kid years ago, you know? And now it's the 90s kids sharing it.
And then they'll be like, millennials.
This is it. It's like childhoods are childhoods. I mean, yeah, kids have more technology these days. This is absolutely true.
Yeah. Well, it's sort of like, yes, I played outside as a kid, but I also lived, like, you know, an hour away from all my friends, so I played by myself. That was probably not the best way of doing it. My cat was my best friend. We used to do such things.
Yeah, I've had a phone call from your cat. Your cat thought you were a dick.
My cat is dead, thank you very much.
Still thought you were a dick. Everybody, come on, everybody's childhood pet's dead.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, like, that's not a thing.
Well, it was almost, because the other pet we had was a galah, and that was my grandmother's bird, and it was her mother's bird as well, so it was just sort of like, was it her aunt's bird? It was someone in the family's bird. And so it had been, like, through several generations of our family.
Oh, well, that's parents, you see, and a lot of people...
Actually, it was a galah. It wasn't supposed to talk, but it talked. It used to call our cat George. And ask it the time.
Do you know what?
In my grandmother's voice.
I bet if you... that must be as spooky as shit. I bet if you went back over time, you'd find there was a George.
Yeah, definitely. And that George was always asked the time.
Do you know what? I don't actually believe this had happened, so don't take offence. But, like, how funny would it be if, like, George was, like, your grandmother's secret lover?
Oh, no, his name was Joe. He was American.
Your grandmother had a secret lover called Joe.
Well, this was before she met my grandfather, but basically she was actually going to... this was, you know, during the wartime, so there was all the Americans that were there as the Navy is part of World War One.
Oh, right.
Or was it... No, I think it was World War II. In any case, but that she was going to run away with Joe, and didn't happen. She decided she wanted to stay in Australia instead. And then she didn't get married for another 15 years.
Nice. So, yeah, you were saying, like, you played outside. Like, in Australia, playing outside is taking your life into your hands, surely.
No, see, this is the thing. Like, when I was a kid, there was never any fear of that. It wasn't until... No, but the thing is, it wasn't until, like, the drought really started kicking in that we started going, oh, holy shit, there's actually snakes in this area. And there was one Christmas, like, I'd gotten a tin penny whistle, so I was playing it outside, because the cat that we had at the time was absolutely charmed by it. He loved it.
Oh, the timer seems to have gone off, but it didn't buzz, so I don't know how long we've been... how much over time we've gone?
Well, can I just finish telling the terrifying story?
You finish telling the story. We are actually 10 minutes over time, it looks like, from the state of the recording. So, awesome. that's amazeballs. Oh, you know why, don't you? I set my smartwatch to do not disturb so I wouldn't get texts and things popping up.
Yeah, that would be it.
The timer doesn't buzz for me. So, yes, finish your story.
All right, so the cat that we had at the time loved the tin whistle. I was sitting out in the garden with him in my lap playing this thing, and my sister comes out and she says... I think it's time for you to come inside. And I'm like, why? And she said, look up. And I looked up, and there was just a snake hanging above my head. And that was the point that I went, okay, let's go inside. Let's go inside.
I'm struggling to find what this has to do with a cat and a tin whistle.
Well, no, because it was right above us, because I'd obviously called it with the tin whistle.
Snakes come when you... Okay, fine.
Snakes aren't supposed to be able to climb trees, and yet it was hanging in the tree above me. So...
Okay, I'm calling this here. We have gone from puppets in abusive relationships to highly trained snakes. Magical fucking tin whistle snakes.
Yes.
So...
I don't think Rich has got any stories about snakes, so that's going to be interesting.
So that's fucked him right up. So, yes, we have gone from puppets in abusive relationships to highly trained snakes. I would like to thank Resulka for joining me in Richard's stead as he's off doing journalisty things.
Yes. Come back soon, Richard. I'm so lonely. No.
Sorry. Oh, no, that's a bad thing. Especially with all of the racist stereotypes in this game.
Yes, unfortunately.
I apologise. So, my darling Resulka, do you have anything you'd like to pimp or plug?
I'm doing another one of those hidden objects reviews games. Reviews should be out in a couple of days on Valerie Porter, which is one of the earlier hidden objects games. Bells. I will just say bells. Also, gnomes on toilets.
Where do people find this?
On my channel, www.youtube.com/Resulka.
I will link that in the show notes as well, so you'll be able to find that.
And hey, I also make adventure games. www.reventuregames.com. We're working on stuff that hopefully will actually be sold at some point.
Awesome. Yes. I did not know that about you. Now I'm fascinated.
Most of my games are kind of... So, yeah, all the ones that we've got a free are quite... they're quite funny in the kinky way. Richard and I are probably going to be doing a video at some point when he gets back on a game called Miss Metaverse, which is like a really bad beauty contest that apparently was set in the internets, and it is terrible. It's from 1996. It's
Richard
FMV.
Doesn't cover anything that isn't terrible.
Yeah, but don't forget.
Well, he doesn't.
He's not the only one who brings these things to the table. I found Piper. I'm the one who said let's do Blue Heat.
Fucking Piper.
And Blue Heat.
Do you know? I still need to have some fun with re-editing video from that with the Dragonzord summon.
The voices. I'm hearing them again. It's probably a good time. It's probably a good time for us to end this episode since we're so heavily over time.
As for my pimping, thank you very much for watching. Everything we do here at Geek Planet Online is supported by Patreon. Please consider, if you like what we do, popping over to patreon.com/geekplanetonline and chucking us a few shekels to keep us making videos. Don't forget also to check out our parent site at geekplanetonline.com for the best in news, features and reviews and podcasts and ting that we slap up every single day of the week. If you like this video, of course, you know, usual, like, comment, subscribe, that's what you're supposed to say if you're a YouTuber, right? It's been a while since I've done one of these, because
I never do it, so that's fine.
I should have another unboxing video coming up at some point after you see this video, and hopefully Richard will be back soon. One More Go should hopefully be back soon. Oh, it's all been going terribly wrong, I'm really sorry.
And if you want Richard to come back sooner, please support his Patreon at patreon.com/probablyrichard.
Yes, do that. Yes.
Let's pimp somebody that hasn't even showed up. We care about him, though.
We do care about him, but, you know, he didn't show up, so fuck him. That'll be a funny video. We're going now. This is One More Go reminding you that games are for everybody, so spread the love. Bye-bye.